His arm hung out the window.
You girls, there! He spouted in German. What are you doing in this orchard?
We stood up and gathered behind Red, still holding our apples.
What did he say?
Red said from the corner of her mouth.
What do we do?
Roxy whispered.
Do you think he heard us talking?
My first instinct was to run. But he was in a truck and could easily catch us. He drove closer, his tires rolling slowly over fallen leaves.
Say something, will ya?
Roxy said, but even Gail seemed to have lost her voice. I cleared my throat. He was wrinkly, a seasoned old man, an apple farmer if I'd ever seen one, and I'd seen a lot. Only this one was German, and there was no way to know if he'd be sympathetic to a few American women or not, like the pharmacist and his wife had been. He could be friends with the butcher and had been out looking for us. I smiled, quickly making up a story.
Good day, sir, I said in German. We lost our dog. Have you seen a shepherd?
His eyes skirted over Red, Roxy, and Gail, who'd hidden her bandaged arm behind Red.
Nine.
And he paused, noticing our apple cores on the ground, which made the air between us feel very uncomfortable. I cleared my throat again.
Sorry to bother you,
I said, even though it was him who'd stopped us. I promptly turned around and mouthed,
Go, go, go.
And the girls followed me deeper into the orchard, as if we knew where we were going and that it was all right to be there. Through the kindling collected between the trees, the fallen leaves, and apples left to spoil. I felt him watching us from his puttering truck, one arm draped over his steering wheel with a keen German eye. I turned around once, catching a glimpse.